Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am explaining you the concept of quick sort. In this video series, I am trying to explain you the introduction to quick sort, how to develop a logic of quick sort along with the examples, solved examples I am going to cover, and the function of the quick sort that also I am going to cover in this video series. So to know all about the quick sort, please stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. If till today, if you have not subscribed my channel Tech Talks, then please do subscribe my channel and keep the bell ringing. Now let's move the part of the solved example of the quick sort. Before that, you must know the concept of the quick sort. To know more about the quick sort, you can go through my previous video, is nothing but the introduction of quick sort and how to develop a logic. For that, I am providing you a shortcut link in this write up corner. Along with this, in the subscription box or a description box, I am going to provide you the link for all the videos of this video series. So quick sort is the quickest method of sorting. Why it is called as quick sort? Because it is highly efficient in terms of the time complexity. So here the time complexity is very low, so that's why its effectiveness is high, and that's why this is called as a quick sort. It basically uses the concept of divide and conquer type of algorithm. It divides the least and conquers the result, that is the sorted list at the end. And this division is done with the help of method partitioning of an array. So with the help of partitioning, we will be able to divide the array into the smaller arrays or the sub list, and with the help of that, we will be able to sort the data in very quick way. So now here I am going to use the partitioning using pivot with the first method or a way, which is nothing but I am picking the first element as the pivot element from the array. So henceforth I am going to use the pivot element as the first element from the array or the list. Let's start with the example. So this is my array with the first value, which is present at the 0th position, is 10. Second value at the first position is 25. Third value at position 2 is 17. Next value at position 3 is 9. And the last value, which is present at position 4, is 13. So this is my unsorted array before applying a quick sort. Now these are the nothing but the steps that we supposed to apply for the sorting of the set of values with the help of quick sort. So first of all, we supposed to choose a pivot, and here I am going to choose a pivot as the first element always of the list. After this, we supposed to use the method like to start from the first and go in forward direction till the number is less than pivot. And if the condition is wrong, we need to stop at that position. Then we need to move in the backward position in the reverse direction till the number is greater than the pivot. This again the condition that we need to apply continuously, repeatedly, till the condition is true. So if both the conditions are false and if they have not crossed their position, then we need to perform the swapping where we stopped to while moving in a forward direction and when we have stopped while moving in a reverse direction, that both we supposed to swap. And again we supposed to apply the same steps again, that is nothing but moving in a forward direction till the number is less than pivot, moving in a reverse direction till the number is greater than pivot, and if again they have not crossed each other, then we have to swap it again. These steps we supposed to apply repeatedly till both the conditions are true. If both the conditions are false and we have crossed with the with their positions, then we have to swap the pivot and the last number while reversing the list. And after that, we need to perform the partitioning, that is division of the list in two that is in a left sublist and a right sublist, and then again we supposed to start from the first by choosing the pivot from the left sublist and then the from the right sublist. So now let's start to apply the quick sort on the given set of values. I have already given these values as an unsorted list previously. Let's start to apply the quick sort. So choose the 0th element from the list as a pivot, and let's see here 10 is the pivot number which I am going to choose for applying the quick sort. Now let's start from the first value, that let's compare this 25 with 10, whether this 25 is less than 10. No, the condition is false, and that's why we supposed to apply the next step to move in a reverse direction but starting from a last. So now let's compare 13 with the pivot, whether 13 is greater than 10. Yes, the condition true. Let's move backward. Now let's compare 9 to 10, whether 9 is greater than 10. No, the condition is false, and here you can see that they have not crossed their position. So what we supposed to do as a next step, we supposed to swap both the values, that is 25 and 9, and after swapping they will look like this. So 25 will be going to place at the position 9, and 9 will be going to place at position 25. So swapping is done, and now again we have to apply the same steps, that is starting from the first number or from where we have stopped, that is nothing but 9. Compare 9 with pivot. So after comparing 9 with pivot, yes, 9 is less than 10, that's why we need to move forward in the forward direction. And let's compare 17 with 10, whether 17 is less than 10. No, it's not, so that's why we need to stop at this position again. Now let's start from the last. Now let's compare 13 with 10, whether 13 is greater than 10. Yes, the condition is true, so that's why I move in backward direction. Now let's compare 25 with pivot, that is 10, whether 25 is greater than 10. Yes, 25 is also greater than 10, so move backward. So now let's compare 17 with 10. Yes, 17 is also greater than 10. Move backward. Now let's compare 9 with 10. Condition is false, as 9 is not greater than 10. And here you can see that both the they have crossed their position, that is moving in forward direction and moving in backward direction. Both have crossed their position, and if they have crossed their position, we supposed to swap the pivot and the position where we have done, we have stopped the going backward or in a reverse direction. So that is 9. So there is a swapping between pivot number 10 and 9. So let's swap their positions, swap the numbers, and after swapping your array will look like this. And after this you can see that your list is divided into two parts, where its left sublist will be having the numbers which are less than pivot and the right sublist having the numbers which are greater than pivot. So let's apply the same steps in the left sublist. Let's choose it as a pivot, and as it is single number, let's declare this as a sorted number. So that's why 9 is also in a sorted way or at a proper position. Now let's move to the right sublist, where make 17 as a pivot. Now as making 17 as a pivot, let's start for the comparison. So let's keep this as a pivot. Start with the first number, that is 25. If it is, let's compare 25 with 17. While moving forward, we supposed to check that the number should be less than pivot. This is not the true condition, that's why let's keep this number 25 at its position only, and let's start with the end to move in the backward by checking the condition whether the number is greater than pivot or not. No, this condition is also false, and we have not crossed the position while moving in forward and backward direction simultaneously. So that's why let's change the numbers, swap the numbers and their positions, like 25 will be at the position 13 and 13 will be at the position 25. So after swapping they will look like this, and as they have not swapped, as they have not crossed their position, let's start again by comparing or from starting from the same position where we were stopped for going forward and to move backward, that is compare 13 with 17, whether 13 is less than 17, yes, so that's why move forward. Let's compare 25 with 17, whether 25 is less than 17, no, the condition is false and we supposed to stop at this position. Let's start from the end and compare 25 with 17, whether 25 is greater than 17, yes, the condition is true. Move backward and let's compare 13 with 17. But the condition is false as 13 is not greater than 17. And here you can see that we have crossed the position while moving in forward and backward direction. So that's why now it's time to swap the pivot number and the number we have stopped the going backward direction. So that's why swap the positions, swap the numbers at the pivot and the position 3, they are 13 and 17. So after moving or after swapping these numbers, your array will look like this. So 17 is taking the position of 13 and 13 is taking the position of 17. And here you can see that again the list is divided into the two sublists. They are left sublist and a right sublist. Here you can see that after settling the position of a pivot, the number which is present in its left sublist is less than the 17 and the number which is present in the right sublist is greater than 17. And this is the magic of the quick sort. Now as 13, let's move to the left sublist. As 13 is a single number, make it as pivot and declare this as at the proper position. And let's move to the right sublist. Let's 25, a single number is there, make it as pivot and declare it as a sorted number. So in this way, here you can see that this is nothing but the sorted array after applying a quick sort. So in this way, we can apply a quick sort on given set of values. Thank you all dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please subscribe my channel Tech Talk. Please give the comment. Here I am providing you a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks. Along with this, I am providing a shortcut link for a next video of this video series and the whole video series in the form of playlist. Thank you. Stay tuned with Tech Talks. Happy learning. Thank you.